Students, so in our last few sessions we had done few of the poems, and in this session we are going to start with your supplementary reader, A Pact with the Sun. Actually, this book contains few of the moral stories, and we are going to start with the very first chapter of it, A Tale of Two Birds. So first of all, I want to introduce you with the chapter, A Tale of Two Birds. A story of two birds is actually about the story of a mother bird and her two young ones. The mother bird was died in a storm, and the young birds were separated from each other, and each found a different home, a different company, different people. And how did these different companies and different people affect them? The story is all about.
There was a big storm. There was thunder, lightning and rain, and the wind blew down many trees. The tall tree in which the birds lived also came down. A big, heavy branch hit the nest and killed the bird, the mother bird. She was dead.
Fortunately, the two baby birds were saved. The strong wind blew them away to the other side of the forest. And one of them came down near a cave where a gang of robbers lived. And the other bird, he landed outside a rishi's ashram. The days passed and the baby birds became big birds now. So one day what happened that the king of the area, the king of the country, came to the forest to hunt on his horse. And he saw a deer and he just rode after it, just for hunting. He ran deep into the forest and he lost his way. He got tired and he sat under a tree just for the rest. Then suddenly what happened? Someone's voice. Then who was that? Whose voice was that? And what was the voice saying? That quick, hurry up, there is someone under the tree, come and take his jewels and his horse, hurry up or else he will slip away. The king was amazed. Whose voice was that? Then he looked up, and what did he see? He saw that a big brown bird is sitting over the tree, and he is calling someone just for robbing the king. And he quickly got up and he just rode back on his horse and he went away from there. Soon the king came to a clearing which looked like an ashram. It was in Rishi's ashram only. The king tied his horse to a tree only and he sat down just for taking rest. And then suddenly he heard the same kind of voice. And this time what did the voice say? Welcome to the ashram, sir. Please go inside and rest. The rishi will be back soon. There is some cold water in the pot. Please make yourself comfortable. The king was amazed. Again, he looked up. And what did he find there? He found that the same kind of bird, that big brown bird, was sitting upside. And the voice was of the same bird. Then loudly the king said. He said that this one looks like the other bird outside the cave, the first bird. He was amazed that time totally. Then the bird replied, yes, sir, you are right. He is my brother. But he has made friends with robbers and he now talks as they used to talk. He doesn't talk to me even anymore. Just then the rishi entered the ashram. The rishi entered. He again welcomed the king and he again asked the king to take rest. But the king was actually in dilemma. He was eager to ask the rishi about those two birds. So he told the whole story of those two birds to rishi. The rishi smiled, the holy man, and he replied then that after all, one is known by the company one keeps. The bird has always heard the talk of robbers, the first bird. So he imitates them and he just turns like the robbers only. Similarly, the second bird, he repeated whatever he had listened, and he also becomes like the rishi. So he used to welcome the people. He thinks about their comfort, exactly opposite of the first bird. So the moral of the story is that one is always known by the company one keeps. So this was all about the first chapter of A Pact with the Sun.